So when you wrapped up with Christopher, you had successfully loaded some data, split it into training and test data, and even trained a model. And so now the next step was basically to see if the model could make predictions, and if so, how accurate are those predictions? So you know if you can trust the results coming from your trained model, and if it's going to make sense to make business decisions or to make changes based on the predictions. Can you trust the predictions from your model? So we need to be able to test our model and get a sense of how accurate the predictions are. So what we're going to need first, though, is to rerun some of our code we saw earlier. So I'm just going to import all the same libraries you were using in the code with Christopher when you were training your model. And I'm just going to rerun the same code that you were looking at that was going ahead and said loading our data set, still working with the flight data set, getting rid of the rows with null values, splitting up our features and our labels, the values we're using to train the model and the value we're trying to predict, and then splitting that into training and test data. So that's all code you'd seen before, and you finished with that one little line of code. You know, it's crazy. You put all this work and think data science is going to be so complicated to train a model, and you discover training a model is all of one line of code. It's preparing the data, but really takes up most of your time. Now that we have trained the model by calling fit, we have a trained model, we call the predict method to actually make a prediction. And now if we're going to predict values, we need to be able to predict values if we want to check accuracy. We'd like to make some predictions for values where we actually know what the actual outputs were. That's why we put aside that test data, because we have a whole bunch of rows inside X test for which we actually know what happened. We know how many minutes late those flights were. That's the values we stored in Y test. So if we pass the values in X test, which are all a bunch of flights where we know what happened, and we say to the model, hey, predict what the flight delay will be for each of these records, then we can compare the predicted values to the actual values. So that's exactly what we're going to do. So if we look at our code, though, it's really only one line. We're going to call regressor, which if you remember up here, that was what we called our linear regression object, which we just trained. Now we can ask that trained model to predict values for each row in X test, and we're going to put those in a data frame called Y predict. So we're going to put that into Y predict, and now it's done, and you can print those values out, and you can see all the different values it's predicted for each row. And then you can compare those values to the actual values we had put aside for each of those toast rows when we did our splitting of our data, and you can see that for the first row, the actual delay, it was 5 minutes early, that first flight, whereas our model predicted it would be about 3 minutes late. The second row, the actual flight was 12 minutes early, and our model predicted it was going to be about 6 minutes late. Third row, it predicted it would be 4 minutes late, when the actual value was about 9 minutes early. So I can see that my model's maybe not quite perfect yet, and this is where you need to go look into those data science courses, and you would learn techniques to go back and see how you get better accuracy on your model. But we're focusing on the code part here, and you can see here we have that ability to take our test data, pass it to the model, and get back predicted values. What I'll take a look at in the next module is some mathematical calculations you can do to get a better sense of accuracy, because reading through all those rows manually could be a little clunky.